Good afternoon and thank you for joining us today when we are talking about innovation and incubation in India. I have with me Professor Anil Sahasrabudhe, who is the chairperson of All India Council for Technical Education, and Mr. R. Ramanan, who is the managing mission director for Atal Innovation Mission. Thank you for joining us and giving us your time, sir.
Thank you.
I like to begin this conversation by asking you, what do you think is the role of startups and entrepreneurship in today's India?
So, first of all, you know, you have India is opening up a number of startups across the country, but many of the startups don't have the necessary support for growing. They don't even have access to a lot of things that they should have access to in order to be successful. For example, if a startup has to be successful, it needs access to technical labs, technology labs which they are associated with. They need access to venture capital. They need access to human resources. They need access to very good mentors and trainers. And they also need management help. And they need help related to business modeling and business planning and so on. Now, these are all things which an incubator provides. So an incubator is an essential part of any success of any startup. And we have to ensure that all these support arrangements and ecosystem of support is available. And that is why you need to have a world-class incubator associated with any startup.
Would you like to say something, sir?
Yeah, I think since our Honorable Prime Minister launched what is known as Startup India, Stand Up India, AICTE took up this whole initiative very seriously and had a committee constituted for evolving a startup policy itself for All India Council for Technical Education. And we had an excellent committee which gave us the policy which was launched by Honorable President of India on November the 16th during last year, you know, during the visitors conference which is held annually for all the directors and vice chancellors of central universities and directors of IITs. I think this is a very way forward, as rightly pointed out by Ramanan. I think tomorrow our number of jobs in large industries is going to be much smaller. Some of the jobs will vanish, some new jobs will emerge, no doubt. But unless students from the portals of their colleges learn the habit of entrepreneurial abilities, I think there is no future. And therefore, in every college, there must be facilitation for having a startup. There must be incubators, there must be accelerators. And I'm sure that there is a lot of talent in India. AICTE conducted what is known as Smart India Hackathon with 598 problem statements from different government departments. And that itself was a roaring success. You know, when students have all the ability,
absolutely,
only that we need to provide them platform,
sure,
to come forward.
Sir, could you also, you mentioned that the startup policy was launched. Could you also tell us more about this AICTE policy?
The policy envisages that, you know, along with your normal course curriculum, which is civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, whatever you are learning, why don't you have 3 to 4 courses at least which are as electives, wherein all the requirements of startup, you know, whether it is in terms of finance, business modeling, you have to have a business plan, how do you get finances, angel funding. If there are courses of all this nature, students will get trained. And right from first year, whatever their innovative idea is there, they start practicing it. And by the time they graduate, they will not only have a startup which is emerging from the portals, instead of seeking job, they will provide job to their batchmates or juniors, about 10 of them. This is the start.
So this is a wonderful idea, which means that in the course curriculum itself, a lot of training on entrepreneurship is going to be included.
Yes, absolutely.
Is this going to be across all colleges?
No, this is a facility which we, all the affiliated colleges to universities will have this facility available. But however, it is the autonomous colleges which have a more freedom actually to take care of this. And therefore, in the first phase, we want that all the autonomous colleges should start practicing.
Okay.
And we will work with Niti Aayog, whether it is Atal Incubation Mission,
yeah,
or even the tinkering labs which are there in the schools.
Sure.
I think there is a give and take between the two, and we'll have matching, you know, which will happen between the colleges and the schools to create an innovative climate in the country. You know, it's ambitious.
Actually, just touching base on that, the Atal Innovation Mission and AICTE have a very strong relationship right now. Where what we are trying to do is, one, the Atal Innovation Mission is having Atal Tinkering Labs at the school level.
Absolutely.
And at the school level, we are setting up these labs so as to be able to promote an innovative mindset in the students. But we need good mentors for all of this. And AICTE has agreed that many of their engineering institutions, the top engineering institutions close to a particular school, will be able to help mentor through its both its academic professors as well as students who want to be participating. Now, the other important thing is this becomes a feeder into the colleges, and so Atal incubators will be also set up in AICTE institutes, and these incubators will then provide a further ground for the students to start innovating, get associated with startups, and start becoming entrepreneurial. So it is a very holistic approach that we are having, where one system feeds into another, and the other helps the feeder to grow and expand.
That's wonderful. I'm sure this will do wonders for the having more and more innovations in the country. We have started receiving some questions from our participants on Facebook, and let me just start asking the questions very quickly. So Radhakrishnan from Xavier's Institute of Management, Cochin, is asking, Cochin is home to 400 plus tech startups. We want to constitute a local startup ecosystem and mentor them. How can we do that?
So this is an ideal question, actually, and it's asked by whom?
Radhakrishnan.
So Radhakrishnan, you have asked a very good question. You have 400 startups, and you want to make sure that they get an ecosystem where you are able to provide necessary support, necessary help for them to grow. And that is why we would urge incubators to be set up, an Atal incubator application to be set up in that particular location, associated with some engineering institute or even otherwise privately funded, and maybe some corporates can fund, or you, a group of you can get together to start an incubator. But that is exactly the type of support and the ecosystem that we want to provide through Atal Incubation, so that your institute is able to address, or these 400 startups are able to address the needs that they are badly looking for.
We are also looking at creating a database of people who have been first generation entrepreneurs or those who are from industry, and they must act as mentors for these new startups.
Correct.
Because one of the important things is many times they miss out on very vital points, and then the failures occur in those startups.
Absolutely.
So I think the mentoring is one important thing which we are addressing through this kind of thing.
And this is a very important point which you have made, because this is exactly where many startups come up with a brilliant idea, but from idea to execution, there is a big gap. And this gap has to be bridged through adequate mentoring support, through adequate access to technology, through adequate access to venture capital, or even hiring or management and so on. A lot of things go to make a startup a success. And all these elements come in together when there is a collaboration between academic engineering institutions, incubators, as well as the startups.
No, absolutely. Very well said. Mentoring is definitely the core of incubation. The next question is from Sandeep. He's asking, can co-working spaces also apply for incubators?
Yes, co-working spaces could also apply for incubators. The details of the online application provide you the guidelines, as well as they provide you the necessary requirements in terms of application for an incubator. We are not stopping anybody from applying for an incubator. However, you have to ensure that the terms and conditions, there are some basic terms and conditions which need to be met, and once they are met, you would qualify and you would be able to apply and secure a grant through the incubators.
Our next question is from Sasi Kumar Ratnasabhapati. He's asking, is there any minimum number of research projects that should be completed for applying to an Atal Incubation Center?
Thanks, Ratin, for this question. The answer is there are no requirements for research projects to be completed. The requirement of an incubator is how is it going to facilitate a set of startups which are associated with it, how it is going to help them, what are their needs, what support they need in terms of access to technology, in terms of seed funding, in terms of hiring, in terms of all the other aspects that are related to make the startup successful. So it is the startups will be identifying projects which they are going to work with and which they are going to grow. So there is no requirement that you should already have research projects in order to apply for an incubator.
Our next question comes from Ankush Mahajan. He's asking, we are a bunch of self-motivated team of IPR consultants. How can we support Atal Innovation Mission?
Ankush, would you like to take this question?
No, I think we welcome anyone who is trying to help in IPR. Mm-hmm. Well, we found that right from polytechnic education to engineering education, many students in their final year, whatever engineering projects they do, there is a lot of innovation involved, and some of that can be converted into a patent.
Correct.
And many of these college students do not have awareness about what is IPR and how do they make use of that. I think if you are IPR consultants, you are most welcome to associate with any nearby college which is there, and we will support you in every form.
Yeah, and I just want to add, Ankush, that you could be a mentor for IPR for many of the startups associated with that incubation center. So we have a list of incubation centers which are already there, and which are new ones will be set up. So you could play a different role. You can get associated with the startups. Of course, if you have your direct relationship with the startups associated with an incubator, then you could provide them the necessary consulting help. But from our perspective, if you can also register yourself as a mentor to help many of these incubators provide this very vital element of understanding what IPR is, how do you file a patent, and what is patentable, and so on.
I would like to add that we would also like to have workshops conducted in different institutions, bringing students and faculty from nearby colleges and create awareness about IPR.
Absolutely. And that is. I mean, wherever there are incubators, we will be having outreach events where we would like people like you to get associated with, come and attend these, and maybe even participate in conducting a workshop or in conducting an awareness session for all of these.
Sir, this question is specifically for you. Mayur Pathak is asking, is there any program from AICTE to PGDM for startups?
No, this program, what I said about AICTE startup policy, is meant for all institutions under the umbrella of AICTE, which includes all engineering schools, architecture, pharmacy schools, management schools, including PGDM institutions, as well as applied arts and crafts institutions which come under AICTE. Mm-hmm. So the startups could be in a variety of areas. It's not necessary, it's always only in engineering. It can be management related, it can be an applied arts and crafts.
Correct.
And variety of areas.
Yeah,
we support that.
Thank you so much for joining us today, sir, and it was great to have you here.
Yeah.
We look forward to your support in the Atal Innovation Mission, as well as the Atal Incubation Centers and the Atal Tinkering Laboratory.
Yes, we have signed an MOU and we will be committed to working together,
thank
you
so
much. For
thank you.
Facilitating
thank you.
That.
Thank
you so much.
I look
thank
forward
you so
to your
much.
Help.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. We will now continue with our Facebook session, and please let the questions keep coming in. Our next question is from Syed Shahjahan. He's asking, how many PhD scholars are required to apply for AICs?
There is a preferred requirement of about 25% of PhD scholars for AICs. This is a preferred requirement, but we would like to have your application. I think it is more important to look at the application holistically and address all the aspects. What exactly are your primary areas of focus? Do you have PhD scholars associated with those areas of focus? And these are some of the things that you have to look into. So I would encourage that look at the application holistically and comprehensively rather than just focusing on one element of it.
Nishant Kumar is asking us, how many incubators does AIM plan to establish in 5 years' time?
We have already set up 20 incubators during the last year, or 19 incubators during the last year. And our aim is, the larger vision for this, for incubation as well as our tinkering labs, is all the good engineering institutions who are committed to have incubation and who have a plan and who have a focus should be applying for all these incubators. So we have not put up an upper number or a lower number for this. But I would say that if you have a smart city, you have 100 smart cities, each smart city should see that they have at least one Atal incubator there. And so it is important for all the institutions in a particular smart city to apply. Similarly, every state, you have the top academic institutions, they should all aspire to have an incubator. And whether you get an Atal incubator or not, to have an incubator associated with an engineering institution is a very important thing, because it gives the students the opportunity to use the incubator, to get associated with startups, to create a movement which is very essential in this country. Because we want a startup movement, we want job creation capability, and our Indian students are extraordinarily brilliant. They have the ability to do it. You just have to have the passion, the commitment, and the application to do it.
Our next question is from Ashwini Kumar. He's asking, can we open more than one incubation center in one college? Our college is in North India, but we want to set up the center in Northeast. Can we do that?
can you open more than one incubation center in one college? Theoretically, the question, the answer to that is you could probably open multiple incubation centers. But the practical issue that you have to deal with is, can you handle more than one incubation center? Are you in a position to create it as a world-class incubation center? It is better for us to create one world-class incubation center than 10 very ordinary, mediocre incubation centers. So I think when you do this application, you have to have a clear area of focus. You should know what am I setting this incubator for. You should have some areas that you want to focus on, and you want to make sure that this becomes a world-class incubator which is scalable. Because you don't need multiple incubators. You need one incubator which can scale and become a very big incubator. If it is successful, it will become.
There's one more question that we'd like to understand is, who should ideally be setting up the incubator, or who's the right candidate? Is it should it be a R&D institution, should it be an academic institution, or a corporate sector entity which should be setting up the incubator?
Actually, all of the above can set up incubators. But the key thing that I would think is important in setting up an incubator is, do you have a clear plan? Do you have a plan for how this incubator is going to support startups? Do you have an idea about what sort of startup community you want to attract? Do you also have you paid attention to the ecosystem around you to ensure that you're going to get students, you're going to get startups, you're going to have a venture capital access feasible? While Atal Incubator is going to facilitate all that through our network, you first of all have to have a plan, and a good plan at that. And you need to also identify some essential components. Like, you should have a CEO for running an incubator. An incubator cannot be run as one of those additional things that you do in an institution or in a college. It has to have a dedicated focus, so you need to have somebody who runs it. And you need to have the necessary access to space and facilities which are there. They should have a certain minimum standard, because when you're talking about an incubator and you're supporting startups, you have to facilitate a whole lot of things. A conference room, for example, for a startup. Do you have one which is going to help the startups invite for presentations and so on? So a lot of those things are there. So have the right focus, have the passion, you become the right candidate.
Dr. Ashoka Varthanan from Sri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology is asking us, is availability of an existing incubator mandatory for applying to AICs?
No, the availability of an existing incubator is not a mandatory requirement for AICs. AICs, in fact, the AIC application is for those who are wanting to set up a new incubator. There is another application which will be shortly floating out for existing incubators who want to scale up. So that is a different type, where you already have an existing incubator and you are wanting to scale up and you are looking for help and support in that. So that will be a separate application which will be soon rolled out, which you can apply for if you have an existing incubator.
Okay. Mr. Ajay Chandak is asking us, we are a technology institution and wish to start an incubation center for innovators. I personally have initiated 36 patents and commercialized a few. How can I use my experience for students and other innovators?
First of all, you could register yourself as a mentor for incubators. You know, that is, with all the experience that you have, it is important that you share this experience and help others become world-class incubators and support the startups associated with that. And secondly, if you are yourself associated with a particular incubator, or you are associated with an academic engineering institution, you can help help them in applying for this particular incubator, Atal incubator application, or an existing incubator which needs to be scaled up.
Our next question is from Anshul Mittal. He is asking, how many colleges will be provided with this grant this year, and is there a fixed number for government and private engineering colleges?
Who's that? Anshul.
Anshul.
Yeah. Anshul, there is no number that we have frozen upon. The idea is, we want qualified applications. And if you are a qualified applicant, we want to make sure that we find a way to support you through the Atal incubation scheme. So the important thing, and it doesn't, we are not restricting it to government, non-government, or private and government and so on. We want to support any worthy applicant for this. So the important thing is, are you a worthy applicant? Qualify yourself well. Take interest in the application. Last time we found many of them had approached the application itself in a manner that did not do justice to what they were asking. I mean, after all, we are looking at a grant of sizable grant ranging anywhere up from 5 to 10 crores. And if you are looking at that sort of grant, you have to take this application seriously. You have to do some thinking, serious thinking. There are a lot of objective questions, but there is also an opportunity within the application for you to give a qualitative write-up and evidences of what you are trying to do. And that makes it a good application, and that qualifies automatically. And we are not putting any numbers on it.
Susma Cherian is asking us, how is Neeti expecting the Atal Incubation Center to be self-sufficient in 5 years? And what are the various avenues for revenue generation?
Yeah, so first of all, any incubator should aspire to become self-sufficient. If you are not, then you are actually not becoming successful. So one of the parameters that you should set for yourself, if I were an incubator applicant, is how I can become self-sufficient. So I am getting the necessary funding to start off this. But if I have a very good plan, and I have and I create the ecosystem for startups to be successful in my incubator, then your incubator is going to be successful. And automatically revenue sources and generation will start. You know, if you're a good incubator, more and more startups want to get associated with you. More and more venture capitalists want to get associated with you. More and more mentors want to get associated with you. And then you have more and more students from universities who want to join startups associated with your incubator. That defines the success of the incubator. The revenue becomes an automatic side effect of all of that. So I would urge that anyone who is thinking of applying for an incubator should ensure that these parameters are being taken care of, and not only in the application but subsequently, and that's what will make you very successful.
We have Dhal Ankur asking us, can AIC accept funding under CSR initiatives?
We are not bothered about the source of your funding, where you have to fund your portion if you're an existing incubator. For Atal Incubation, for Greenfield incubators, if they are for government and R&D institutions, the funding is being provided, initial funding is being provided by Atal Incubation mechanism itself. What we do expect is that for you to be sustainable in the long run, you should start finding sources of funding through corporates or through NGOs or through investment houses. You will find that that is happening. The more and more you are able to have a very successful incubation plan and incubatees who automatically draw such people and the sources of funding. CSR funding is fine. I think that is not a problem.
Kirti Pavar Bharti is asking us, what will be the expectations from the incubation centers after establishment? How will their performance be evaluated?
Yeah, very good question. And Bharti.
Kirti.
Kirti, very good question. And I'm glad you raised this, because many people stop with the funding itself and then don't want you to ask any more questions from them. So this is something that is important. We want to make sure that you are successful. So how do we ensure that we are successful? We will define a set of parameters which will govern your success. There are certain leading parameters, leading indicators related to your own way of progressing. There are several milestones that you will give during the business plan for the incubator. We will be making sure that you are adhering to the business plan, and we will also be looking at 8 or 9 parameters which we will define to all the incubators, which they are supposed to monitor, and we will also monitor to ensure that they are successful. So through this, it will be an online monitoring mechanism, as well as visits to your incubation facility by a team of people appointed by Atal Innovation Mission. So there will be multiple mechanisms for us to ensure that the whole funding is actually having an outcome, and the outcome is a world-class incubator from your side. So it is very important for you to keep that in mind, and we will be evolving these parameters as we go along. Some of the parameters will be applicable more for a particular set of incubators, and some other parameters may be more applicable for another. For example, your incubator may have a venture capital related issue, some others may have a technology access related issue. We want to make sure that the right focus is there.
Ajay Rana is asking us, can we apply for AIC on the behalf of group of institutions comprising of various affiliating universities?
I don't see an issue on that. You could, as long as there is a single applicant and there is ownership by the applicant for the successful running of the incubator. We have to make sure that that is very clear. We don't want this ownership to be diffused, because the moment it is diffused, somebody is going to be pointing fingers at somebody else in order to say that my incubator was not successful and so on. We want ownership, we want accountability, and if it is a group of institutions joining together, joining hands, great. We feel that if you have more stakeholders in an incubator, they are going to make sure that it is successful.
Manju Chattopadhyay is asking us, what are the main components of an incubation center, say in terms of number of teachers available, their specialization, facilities, department, so on?
So Manju, that is, the application is quite comprehensive in what it expects for a successful application. So please go through the online application. There are a lot of details. If there are very specific questions that still remain in your mind after going through the application, send a mail to us and we'll be more than happy to answer those questions. But otherwise, it's pretty clear. The application process itself is very simple. The questions are very clear. But if there is any additional information that you need, feel free to apply or to approach us.
The next question is, should we consider lease of premises out of the college dedicated for incubator as a part of the college contribution? This is being asked by Mr. Satya Prakash Mishra.
Lease of premises for the purposes of incubator?
In a college. So
I just want to make sure that you understand from an incubator point of view, from our requirement point of view, you should have the space. Now, whether that space is your own space, which you have, or it is a lease space, it doesn't matter to us. You should have a dedicated space which is sustainable over a period of time, not that you run out of rent next year and then no longer this place is no longer available. We'd like to see evidence and commitment that over a period of time when the grant is being given, you are actually having that space. Now, if you rent or lease or acquire the space, that is immaterial to us. The cost of that cannot be funded through the grant. That is your cost. Whoever is supporting you, whether the college is supporting you or a set of investors are supporting you, that doesn't matter. But the cost, you cannot use the grant funds in order to pay the rental or the lease or the acquisition of space.
Our next question is, can we have an additional focus on social innovation? Also, can we work or apply in collaboration with an existing DST-funded incubator? This is by Ishwar Haridas.
So Haridas, innovation per se from an Atal innovation mission point of view touches both social innovation as well as commercial innovation. So we are not here to really distinguish between the two. What we need is a very clear plan that if you're saying that a set of startups associated with your incubator is focusing on social innovation, we'd like to see what are the outcomes that this social innovation is going to have. How are you going to measure it? How are you going to manage it? How are you going to get the right resources for it? So that's what we'd like to understand, and that qualifies for a good application. So yes, if you are focusing on social entrepreneurship and social innovation, it is great. We encourage that. At the same time, make sure that we have a very clear outcome-driven social innovation plan.
Indian Electronic is asking, we are a startup working in the field of STEM education for students from age group 6 to 30 years. Can we set up an incubation center with assistance from AIM?
An incubation center has certain requirements in terms of what type of institutions can apply. So please make sure that it falls under that category. We have two initiatives, as I have mentioned. Atal Tinkering Labs is at a school level for grade 6 to grade 12 students. So we don't expect grade 6 to grade 12 students to come up with an innovation which is commercially oriented immediately. Of course, there are brilliant students even in the 10th or 11th who can come up with some products which are having commercial possibilities. We don't rule out that. But the aim of the Atal Tinkering Labs is to create and foster a spirit of innovation in the students. The Atal incubators, on the other hand, are serious incubators hosting startups who are going to create products or services for commercial or social benefits. So that is a different game altogether. and we want to make sure that the right applicants are there. And therefore, it is associated right now with higher engineering institutions, higher academic institutions, and or other institutions which are able to support the effective functioning of an incubator.
Manikam Ramaswamy is asking us, is it necessary to start incubation by PPP mode only? Will Niti Aayog support for existing social enterprise incubators also?
Yeah, so we have two applications. One is the current application, which is already online, is for new incubators, greenfield incubators. That is another one which will be floating shortly for existing incubators. And when you're talking of existing incubators, we are saying we need to see a clear plan from you for how you have been performing and how you want to scale and what is the justification for that. So based upon an analysis of your application, we'll be able to give you the appropriate grant.
Sudesh Kumari is asking, are there any mandatory set of trainings that an AIC needs to conduct?
Any incubator worth its name will have to conduct good training for its people, for the startup managers, for the entire setup. I mean, at the end of the day, if you are not trained well, you are not going to ensure the success of the incubator or the startups associated with that. So a good training program is important. You should conduct training programs. You should solicit training programs. There are a lot of knowledge sharing sessions that you should organize. You should be able to invite speakers from outside so that they are able to contribute and tell what makes a successful startup, what makes a successful incubator. All of this has to go into the mix. Otherwise, an incubator cannot just be a leasing agent saying that here is a cubicle and you do whatever you want and we don't even know what you're doing. So training is important and all of these are important, and that's what goes to make a very successful incubator.
What should be the size of manpower and what infrastructure will be required? This is asked by Professor Shashikant Patil.
Again, this is also specified in the application, but at a minimum, you need to have not only the space requirements which we talked about, you need to have a CEO or an identified manager who is going to run this incubator. You need some supporting from admin, finance, hiring point of view. You'll need appropriate support. You will need to have a set of mentors associated with your incubation facility. The more you show evidence of all of this, that you have already started approaching, you already have identified some supporting academic institutions who says that they will be willing to support your incubation, that they will give access to their research labs and so on and so forth, this becomes a plus point in your application. So my suggestion is look at what makes a successful incubator. Please don't apply blindly for all of this. Have some research done on what goes into making a good incubator and what is your plan to make sure you're confirmed to that, and what do you need to do and what do you already have. All of this, if it comes into the application, it becomes a very strong application and becomes a good contender for the grant.
What are the particulars of spending under recurring and non-recurring expenses according to the proposed budget? This is a question sent by Deepak Saxena.
I think we don't need to go into the details. Again, that is spelled out in both in the application guidelines as well as in the application itself. So please go through that. There are certain things which are related to CAPEX and there are certain things related to OPEX, and the CAPEX obviously, the facility will be included in that, which you have to invest in. The OPEX is what mostly the grant will be able to cater to, which what it can cater to has also been specified.
Here's a question from an entrepreneurship development cell, Sona. How does a faculty register as a mentor?
So two things. One is to register as a mentor for the incubator, you could independently talk to the incubator and register as their mentor. So I don't think that we have any issue or any requirement for registration of a mentor with an incubation facility. But if you want to register also as a mentor with Atal Innovation Mission to be allocated to any particular incubator, then we will be coming out with a process of requesting, registering for mentors, and you can apply. There will be an online application for mentors which will be launched soon. Once that application is on, you can register yourself as a possible mentor and stating your areas of expertise and the location where you are, so that we can then allocate or associate you with a particular incubation facility?
Here's a question from Vaibhav Sharma, professor in Krishna Kumar Pandey Faculty of Engineering, Tirthankar Mahavir University. We are a university in Muradabad and the city has a huge brass industry which needs innovation. Can we set up an incubator here or do we need to wait for startups in this field to come up first? It's a very interesting question we have here.
First of all, I think it is commendable that you have identified an area which you want to focus on from an incubation point of view. I do think this has to be a parallel exercise. You cannot start an incubator and wait for startups, nor can you start startups without associating with an incubator. So, you know, this is a catch-22 type of question. I think you have to initiate right away a search for possible startups to be associated with your incubator. You have to find out, is there a sufficient body of interest in startups associated with the area that you have mentioned? And or should you make it a little more broader area to attract more startups? So please look at that. Please do your homework, which is important. But we would encourage incubators in multiple areas, as long as you have a clear focus area. We want you to have some clear focus area so that you're not sort of making it so open that nobody knows why I should be approaching your incubator.
Arjun is asking us, how long is the incubation period for startups? What is the course of action if a startup fails?
What is it?
How long is the incubation period for startups? And what is the course of action if a startup fails?
No, startups and incubators are two different things. A startup should succeed. A startup's chances of success are greater if it is part of an incubator. What happens is, I guess, the incubator will have certain expectations from every startup. And if you are not meeting those expectations, whatever terms and conditions that you have agreed upon with that incubator, then many incubators may ask you to exit or you may want to exit yourself. So that is something that you have to negotiate with the incubator. From our perspective, we want you to be successful, so you should not be thinking of failure. If you're thinking of failure right now, you better don't apply and make sure that you think of what will make you successful before you apply for this. Because it is important for not only the startup to succeed, but the incubator to succeed. You should have a clear plan. You should have confidence in what you're trying to do. You should have a business opportunity that you're addressing. And with all of this, I'm sure you'll succeed.
Suresh is asking us, has AIM formulated a minimum specification with regards to the building area and the number of faculty members for mentoring, etc., for getting approval as an Atal Incubation Center?
There are some minimum requirements that have already been specified in the application. So please go through that. But what we also want to see is, when you give a plan, are you having an appropriate number of people, resources, to be able to address that particular plan? If you say, I'm going to support 10 startups, then do you have the appropriate number of resources to handle those 10 startups? That is what we'll be looking for in your business plan. So please make your business plan realistic. We don't mind an ambitious business plan, but an ambitious business plan should be supported by a very comprehensive plan on resourcing, on financing, and so on and so forth. So that is very important when we are looking at an application.
Here's a question from MGIT Hyderabad. Baba Satyadev Palanki is asking us, how much initial investment is needed to apply for Atal Incubation Centers?
There is no particular, if you're an existing incubator, there is a matching fund that will be required for Atal Incubation. But for the Atal Greenfield Incubator that we are talking about, that should be a plan. You have a project cost. We are going to be funding part of the project cost, up to 10 crores. So you cannot be relying fully on the project cost to be borne by Atal Incubation. If your project cost is going to be higher, then we want to evidence that that is going to be supported through the network of investors in your organization, in your incubation, or the institute which you're associated with, and so on. So please make sure that plan is addressed, and you are able to show what the total project cost is, and out of which, because the facility has to be yours. So if the facility has to be yours, you have to have a minimal amount of investment in order to have that facility. And then all the other things, what is the other investment you are bringing in? We really want applicants to show that beyond Atal incubation investment, there are other investors who would be interested in supporting you, because that gives additional strength to the application, and we have multiple stakeholders in your application, which makes us more comfortable that, you know, you are worthy of consideration.
Do you support setting up AICs in tier 3 towns so that rural India is not left out? This is a question by Kandaswamy Swami.
Yes, of course, we are looking at supporting in the rural places. The incubator, we want incubators to be set up across the country. Now, the important thing to also realize is, are we setting up the incubators at the right places where you have access to the right resources in order to make yourself successful and the startup successful? So you need not set up an incubator at a rural place in order for addressing the rural needs. You can set up an incubator in a smart city, or you can set up close to that, but make sure that your incubator has adequate access to resources. I mean, people are important, companies are important, the infrastructure is important. If all of these are missing, you're going to find it difficult for the incubator to succeed or the startups associated with that to succeed. But nothing prevents any incubator from addressing an opportunity for the rural marketplace or for the underprivileged. So please look into that part when you're considering the location of the incubator.
Priyanka Gupta is asking us, will innovative software application-based ideas also be considered under AIC, or is the focus on product-based ideas alone?
Can you repeat that?
Is innovative software application-based ideas also be considered under AIC, or is the focus on product-based ideas alone?
No, I think we are not restricting it only to product-based. And software is also a product in today's definition. So if you have a software-based product or you have a hardware product, it doesn't matter. As long as that, but that is again a question of the startups associated with the incubator. The incubator is like the umbrella organization which is supporting multiple startups. If the startup is focusing on software-based, if the incubator is focusing on software-based startups, it is fine. If it is focusing on both software and hardware, that is also fine. But we want to make sure that the incubator is clear about what they are supporting, what is their priority area of focus, and what is the type of startups they want to attract to their fold, so that you are providing the ecosystem in a very focused manner, and you are not having to cater to very diverse needs of diverse startups, which you are not able to, you know, manage. So you have to be able to manage the needs of various startups. So you need to have technology labs, for example, associated with what you want. And this is what you should look for when you're deciding to be associated with an incubator or to start an incubator.
Okay, we are down to our, we are out of time, so we are going to take another one or two questions at most. Alok is asking, I want to apply for Atal Incubation Center in the agricultural sector. Is it necessary that I should invest in the incubation sector, center?
Alok, if you are associated, if you are starting an incubation center associated with an academic or engineering institution or a R&D institution, then you can apply along with that institution. And there's no constraint. If you are a corporate or you are private or you are an existing incubator, you will have to show matching funds from that particular incubator if you are an existing incubator. What we also want is for people, the applicant, to have some teeth in the game. So we want to make sure that you are not just applying for the fund, but you also have some stake. Because that gives us a comfort factor that you have some stake in this and you are putting your best effort to make this incubator successful. So that would definitely go in the weightage that the application has. Are you investing in it? And if you are not,
what are your sources of investment so that we feel comfortable that there are enough people having stake in your incubation facility so that our grant will also can be leveraged for that purpose.
Yes, our question from St. Anne's College of Engineering and Technology, Chairala, Andhra Pradesh. Shriram is asking, can we give access to people from outside the institution also?
Yes, Shriram, it's a very good question and a good suggestion. The incubation facility, because it is funded by the government, we actually want to encourage you to have access to your incubation facility from other institutions. You can have a formal relationship with them and you can say in the application that these are the institutions to whom this incubation facility will also provide extended access to. That I think will go in your favor when you give an application mentioning all of that. But we also want some evidential documents which it's not, it should not just be a statement, but it should be backed up with suitable documentation.
Folks, well, we have many more questions here, but that's all the time that we have for today. So we will have to end the session right now. Thank you so much for your time, Mr. Ramanan. And for more questions which we could not answer right now, we request you to send an email to md-aim@gov.in and we'll get back to you on this.
Thank you.